Welcome back, everybody. Thank you for watching another video. So it's been about 2 weeks now since Morissette's music video came out for Love You Still. And unfortunately for me, I was out in Utah for 2 weeks when it came out. And for all of my viewers in the Philippines, or for anybody that hasn't had a chance to go to Utah, I'll leave some links right up here so you can go check out those parks, because Bryce Canyon and Zion National Park are absolute stunners. But when I was out, this video came out, and I'm so glad it did, because it's a lovely song. I absolutely love it. And I'm glad to see a music video came out with it. Now, I've had a chance to watch it a few times, and there is a lot of things I love about it and some things that make it look a little bit amateurish. So we'll run through it. I'll tell you the things that I love about it and some things that were kind of iffy about it. Now, the things that I look for when I'm watching a music video is the storytelling. I need every scene that I'm looking at to contribute to the story that's being told, because we know that this song is very personal to Morissette and her relationship with her father. So I just don't want things and scenes to be put in a video just because they look nice. I think everything should add to the storytelling, or at least the drama of the situation. And it's a lot of good storytelling. So let's go through this, and I'll give you my opinions on things that I like and things that I don't like. It's like she's searching. Having to look around in the dark. Okay, so here we go. She's on the beach using a lantern. It's dark, so she's obviously using this lantern to look around. She's searching for something. They have her dressed in black, which kind of means like the death of something. You normally see it where people are mourning. So she could be mourning the death of this relationship with her father. And she's hooded, which is curious because she kind of looks like a very feminine, attractive Grim Reaper. The one thing that I would do with this lantern, I love the idea of using the lantern. It looks too new. I would have distressed it, maybe put some sandpaper on it to make it look a little bit more aged. And then another thing, we saw her shawl kind of floating in the water. I don't know what that's supposed to symbolize. I think they just put it in there to put it in there, because throughout the entire song, she has it on. Why she would drop it doesn't make any sense. Okay, now she's looking afraid and cold, kind of lost. Don't know when I last heard the sound of your sweet voice, but sometimes I hear it in my dreams. I love the usage of the message in the bottle, because in the movies, that's what you do when you're stranded on an island and you're feeling alone and you're hopeless, right? You find a bottle, you stuff a message in it, and you throw it, right? And that's maybe kind of symbolizing how she tried to reach out to her dad but didn't get any answer. If anybody knows, I can't tell exactly what's in that bottle. Could be a message, could be something specific to her. I don't know, but I like that usage. Your vision haunting me, this feeling so uneasy. Love lighthouses. I love them. So great, right? When you're lost at sea and you don't know where you're going, you look for the lighthouse to help guide you in. So maybe she's kind of telling her dad, look, I'm here. You can see me. If you want to come, you know, you're welcome back. This one scene, the scene or the picture that I'm looking at exactly at 1 minute, she has the shawl wrapped around her face. She's not really guarding anything because you can see through it. Like, you can actually see her mouth. They probably should have doubled up on that and have it wrapped around her face if you just wanted to have her eyes. Something I didn't like about the mosquito netting. The mosquito netting is fine, but I don't like the way they use those Christmas lights. Number one, what are Christmas lights doing on a beach? There's no place to plug them in. They should have just used another lantern because she's got like three of them there. And in the back over her right shoulder, they have a fire going, but they got this like artificial purple light. That doesn't belong in there. Just natural beach to make it look natural. What keeps them from changing color? Everything's constantly fading. Still hoping and waiting that someday I'd hear you call. Morissette has such a beautiful face. She's got really expressive eyes and facial expressions. I don't like the filter that they're using, that water filter. It really distracts from her face. I probably would have just left the lighting like it is, maybe light it stronger from the front with a key light so it's shadowed on this side, and kept the smoothness of her face because she has such a beautiful complexion and these gigantic eyes. Having that water filter on there really takes away from the expression in her face. Beautiful scenes. That light in the back, LED lights. Beautiful landscaping shots there. So we see in the backgrounds the mountains, she's standing on that pier thing. The water looks like glass. The only thing that I found weird here is when she's sitting in those tide pools, it's so beautiful. You can see just like this lava rock tide pools in there. And she's standing on these rocks. And when the camera kind of backs out, you can see her total outfit. I don't really like what she's wearing. It's like I can't tell if it's shorts or if it's a kind of blouse. We can see her with the shawl or that scarf made out of lace. It's really confusing and it doesn't really do her body shape really good. So I probably would have just gone with like a long flowing dress or something like that. But it looks really weird. But at least you can see her shoulders. I think that's over the shoulder number 3. Okay, so here's one of those things where I think they just put something in there to be dramatic. It doesn't really add to the story. So we've seen her kind of feeling the walls of the lighthouse, and then she looked up like that. If you're on a photo shoot and you're modeling clothing, or maybe you're building your portfolio and you're trying to make a dramatic shot, that's fine if it's for a still picture. But in this setting, how does looking up at the lighthouse add to the story? If anything else, she should be looking to the ocean to see what's coming in at her. There's no reason why she's looking up at the light. You can see, oh, maybe it's on, but you don't have to look up at it like that to see that it's on. So I think that scene there probably wasn't needed. Beautiful playing with the lace. Nice over the camera or the lens with the lace. Loved how they did that, right? I still love you. You got a quick montage of her face just really close in there. 1, 2, 3, 4. I love it when the song mimics the cinematography. You still think of me when you sit down for coffee. Do you still love this backlighting? Not so much there though. Okay, that's well done. So again, it mimics the chaos that's going on in the song, right? The video and the music. You have a real hard beat with the guitar. She's in the water. It seems like she's drowning. Nice use of the camera effect when she's in the water. It gives the effect like she's drowning. She's hopeless. She doesn't have control over the situation. So that was communicated very well. Nails. Awesome image of her kind of floating in the water, and she's trying to reach up for help. She's reaching toward the camera, and I keep seeing this backlit scene in here. So there's two things. She's backlit with that purple light. You can see the smoke coming up. When she's up close to the camera, looks fantastic. Gives a good image. But when the camera backs out and they lose the key light here, it's way too dark. The backlighting is way too strong. You can't see her face. You can barely see her gestures. The only thing you can really see is like the light coming out behind her. So when she's up close, it's great. But when they back up, it's too dark. It's way too strong backlighting. They need a little bit of more light spilling in from the front. Like this. Perfect. There's just a quick example with 320. You really can't see anything. It's all blurred out. They really should kind of focus in more or have a little bit more lighting spilling from the front. And again, if you compare this second half of the video to the first, a lot of more emotion coming out. You can see it in her face. But if one day I'll wake up and tell all that I knew. Beautiful montage. Oh, nice picture of that face. So beautiful. I wouldn't know what to say, but my eyes would give it all away. Ooh, look at this. 3 minutes, 40 seconds. She looks like an absolute angel. The sun is backlighting her again. This is how you use backlighting. So there's probably like a reflector in the front of her taking the sun and bouncing it back onto her face. And the sun, it looks like a halo around her. She looks absolutely gorgeous. This is going to be a slow bottom left, slow gaze upright to the camera, and it's timed immaculately. It's perfect. I still love you. Woo! Stay. I still love you. She loves that lace. Over the shoulder. Alright, so I don't know how many over the shoulders that was, but the point I'm trying to make is it's redundant. You only need maybe about two, I'll give you even three, but there's more than three over the shoulder slow motion looks. Nice, that's a nice shot. That was a great shot, drone shot over the lighthouse. There's a lot of great view or scenic views in this video. And what perfect timing. They got this bird kind of flying overhead. But the problem is, it's too far away. It doesn't really give meaning. They needed to get a little bit closer with maybe a bigger lens. But the meaning of the bird flying overhead, I don't know what it is. But the shot isn't very impactful because the bird is too far away. Alright, that's an awesome video. Overall, beautiful job. The only other thing that I noticed too is, so they're filming on a beach and everything looks exquisite. Everything looks fantastic up until the very ending where they back up and they show her where she's standing and the grass is all patchy. Like there's some nice grass here, there's some burnt out grass here. And then when they show her in the tide pools in the lava rocks, beautiful. The water looks like glass. She's standing in the tide pool area. That looks beautiful. You see shots from maybe the jungle area over to the beach. That's great. But when they back out here in the ending, you can see just how patchy the grass is. And those are just weeds. They're weeds all along the side. Those are beach weeds. And they got like really broke down trees. I probably would not have put that drone shot in because it ruins the beautifulness of the beach. But this last shot, when she's reaching out to the sun, it's like she's reaching out for her dad. You know, I hope things get better between her and her dad. But this music video, I would give it probably an A, but with some room for improvement to get it to the A+. Guys, thank you for watching. I'll catch you in the next video.